Hello guys, my name is Jose Lopez. I'm from Lowrider Tattoo. Here representing my whole team here at the Fiesta Tattoo Convention. I don't really think I have a style, you know. I mean, I like to work just with black and gray. I like to appreciate color, but I don't like to do it myself unless I'm painting. But black and gray is something that is timeless. It just, the longer it sits, the nicer it becomes, you know. So to me, I mean, that's something that's amazing. And right now, it's basically the hottest thing around, you know. At one point, Japanese traditional tattooing used to be like the more popular type of tattooing, but black and gray has taken over. You know, you can apply black and gray tattooing to just about anything. Traveling is definitely something that has influenced me a lot, you know, and it has opened the doors, you know, and like the way I see it, like for example, Hong Kong, you know, tattooing is not as popular over there, you know, so me going over there and making connections over there, like, basically, at one point, it's gonna help the whole tattoo industry, you know?
Right.
Because, I mean, you know, you go and you're basically representing the rest of the world of tattooing, you know? So, you know, they say that one person can't change the world, but I believe that you can contribute to the change, you know? And eventually, tattooing will be everywhere. You know, it's crazy, you know? I never thought I would ever, you know, get to see these places. But again, you know, I just follow the omens, you know, like things unfold a certain way, you know, and one day I'm in Pakistan, you know, in third world country, you know, and another time I'm in Thailand and I get deported, you know, so that leads me to Hong Kong, you know, so I don't really plan things, you know, I just like to live life and, you know, go with the flow, you know, and I let nature just take its course, you know, and, I've been so blessed, you know, I have a beautiful, you know, family, I have a great team, you know, that are part of my family, you know, and that's what keeps me going, you know. Like I said, I mean, without them, I wouldn't be doing anything, you know. The show's amazing. I mean, like the people are like, they're giving us a real warm welcoming, you know. I mean, everybody is just, I don't know, like they're really happy to see us, you know. And I mean, we're happy to be here, you know, so. You know, I haven't done a convention in the States for a very, very long time, you know, but I'm happy to be here, you know, to be here with everybody. You know, Bell, my good friend Brian Everett, I mean, this guy, he's basically the one that, he launched my whole career, you know. You know, one day I met him and he was super nice to me. And funny thing, I didn't even know who he was, you know. I knew of him, but I didn't know what he looked like, you know, so I was just talking to him for the whole day, basically. He sat there in front of the booth, you know, and I was talking to him, and I figured, like, man, this is a cool man, you know. And you know, like the way our booth works, we allowed everybody in our booth, you know, like whoever it is, you know, like we have no boundaries, we don't have no like limitations to anything, you know. You can come and see us work, and you can come and talk to us, you know. So, you know, like back then, we've been like this, you know, we've been like that since the beginning, you know, so I asked Brian to come into the booth without knowing who he was, you know. He was sitting there watching me work, and like you could tell he just loved the way, like, our energy, like the whole vibe, you know. And then he asked me, you know, if I could tattoo him, you know, and I told him I was all booked up, you know, but, you know, he was just so nice that when he was walking away, I called him back and I told him, you know what, I'll do whatever I have to go and I'll tattoo you tomorrow. And later on that night, I found out that was Brian Everett. So that started the whole friendship, you know? So the way it started, you know, like, I didn't know who he was, you know, like, it wasn't like I knew who he was and, you know, like, I expected something, you know? So that created a very, very, very strong friendship, you know? And after that, you know, like, he introduced me to other people and, you know, like, that was back then when nobody believed in us, you know? You know, like, people were, you know, like, people always, like, they like you or they talk to you because you're somebody or whatever, you know? But I like to believe that relationship, it was born out of just naturally, you know? You know, and that's what kept us strong, you know? So I was in Pakistan and he gave me a call, and he asked if I could come and support him here. And like I said, my schedule is super, super, super booked. But I said, you know what, like, man, you know what? No matter what I have to do, like, you can count on me, I'll be there, you know? So now I'm here, now I'm with you guys, and I'm super happy.